Hello and welcome to Storatium. In this two-part tutorial, we're going to look at 8 awesome and easy transitions that you can make in a matter of seconds. Even though you could make a preset for some of them, these transitions are so simple that they don't require a preset, at least in my opinion. This two-part tutorial is a collaboration with the second channel from Cinecom, namely Premiere Basics, presented by Jill.
Hey everyone, glad to be here.
You can find the first 4 transitions in this video and the other 4 in the video that is linked at the end of this one. Anyway, it's time to start some editing after the quick message from our sponsor Videvo.net. Videvo is a great source for free and premium stock footage. For example, all the clips used in this tutorial video are coming from Videvo. And besides the more than 100,000 video clips, they've also got a big collection of music and sound effects. Be sure to check them out and use the discount code STORATIUM20 to claim a 20% discount on one of their premium plans. The links can be found in the video description. Okay, now it's time to jump over to Premiere and look at the first transition. The first one is a simple zoom transition. And I've already got 2 clips ready on the timeline to show you how to do this one. The first step here is creating an adjustment layer. You can do this in the project panel, click on the new icon and then select adjustment layer. And then accept the default settings and click OK. You can now drag this adjustment layer over to the timeline and place this on top of the 2 clips. Then shorten the length of the adjustment layer until it's somewhat equal on both sides. Next, we're going to add an effect. In the effects panel, we're going to search for the transform effect. You'll find this one under video effects distort. I'm going to apply this effect to the adjustment layer and then put the playhead right between the 2 clips. And you can also zoom in to be sure that it's right in the middle. Now I'm going to move over to the effects control panel and I'm going to look at scale properties of the transform effect. First I'm going to enable keyframes by clicking on the stopwatch icon here. Then I'm going to move that first keyframe with value 100 a couple of frames back. And then create another keyframe with value 100 and move that one a bit forward. The playhead is still in the middle between the 2 clips and that's where we're going to create a new keyframe with value 300. And now, as you can see, the zoom effect is there, but it's a little boring. But we're going to improve this by adding a bit of motion blur. We can do this by disabling the option for Use Composition Shutter Angle, and we can set Shutter Angle to 360. And 360 will give the maximum amount of motion blur. If you want a little less motion blur, you can change this to 180, for example. And to make it even more smoother, we're going to right-click on the first keyframe and then select Ease Out. And we'll do the same for the last keyframe and we'll select Ease In. And as a final, optional step, you can also add the cross-dissolve effect between the 2 clips. You might want to do this in case the cut still feels a bit too rough. Adding the cross-dissolve will make this look a lot smoother. You can simply add this cross-dissolve between the 2 clips and make it last a couple of frames. And that's it for this first transition, let's have a look at the final result. And now we're going to jump over to Belgium for the next transition presented by Jill.
Awesome! So for the next transition, we're going to need 2 clips. Place them behind each other in the timeline and cut a part of the second clip. Take this to track number 2 and place it above video 1. Line up the endings of the 2 clips and then drag the end a bit over the second video. Okay, now we're going to cut the top clip in half. On the first part, we're going to place the invert effect, which we can find in the effects panel. Then make a mask from the opacity property. You can choose the shape of this mask, but make sure that it takes up the entire width of your screen. And also don't make the mask too high. Then animate the mask so that it starts off screen in the beginning and slides down until the end of the clip. We can do this by animating the mask path with keyframes. Now this creates a scan effect, but we don't have the full transition yet. So let's take that second half of our clip, place the invert effect on it, and also the crop effect. Now we'll animate the bottom property so that it goes from 100 to 0 in the middle of the clip. Then from the middle section, place a keyframe for the top value and place a keyframe at the end of the clip, making a top value 100. Now don't forget to ease those keyframes. And now we have an X-ray scan transition.
Thanks a lot, Jill. That one was very nice. It's time to move on to the next transition and for this one I've got these 2 clips on the timeline. This time we're going to use a color matte for the transition. To add this, go to the project panel, click on the new item icon and select color matte. You can accept the default resolution and frame rate settings and click OK. Next, you need to pick a color, and for this one, I'm going to select the yellow from the wall behind the man. And it will look even better if we go for a more saturated yellow, and then click OK. And then I'm going to give the color mat the name yellow and click OK. Next, we can add the color mat on top of the two clips and then shorten the length. And in this case, I'll go for a duration of 1 second. And then center it on top of the two clips. And then we need to go to the effects panel and search for the push effect. You will find this one under video transitions slide. Now you can apply this effect to the beginning of the color mat. And then shorten the length until it's right in the middle between the two clips. And then apply a second push transition to the end of the color mat. And now you've got a basic color mat transition. In case you want the transition to go a bit faster, you simply select the color mat and then shorten the length. And then, of course, also reposition the push transitions. And to make it all a bit more exciting, we're going to add another color mat. So I will go back to the project panel, click on the new item icon and then select color mat. I'll accept the default settings and in this case I'll pick the red color on the wall behind the man. And also here I'll go for a bit more saturated variant. Then I'll name this one red and then click OK. Now we can place the second color mat on top of the first one and then offset it for a couple of frames. And also add the push transitions to the beginning and the end of the color mat. And also offset these a couple of frames. That's it for this one, let's have a look at the final result.
And the next transition is a simple glitch transition. Create an adjustment layer and place it above the cut of your videos. Make it about 5 frames long on each side of the cut. Now from the effects panel, look for the VR digital glitch effect and animate the master amplitude, going from 0 to 100 right on the cut and then back to 0 at the end. Then use the distortion properties to customize the look of your glitch. Now these are my settings, but you don't have to copy these exactly. Then we're going to add the VR rotate sphere effect to this adjustment layer and we're going to animate the Z-axis roll, going from 0 to 45 on the cut and then back to 0. And now you've got this awesome glitch transition.
Thanks again, Jill, and that indeed was awesome and easy. And that also concludes this first part of the 8 easy transitions. Let me know in the comments if you would like to see another transition collaboration video with Storyshim and Premiere Basics. And now you can click here to see the other 4 transitions. That's it for this one. Thanks a lot for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.